as it is for Sunday, December 7th, with reports on a controversial hydroelectric project and a new way of teaching gymnastics. I'm Bill Hoagland.
And I'm Marilyn Weston.
Ask any 7-year-old boy or girl what his or her favorite subject in school is. The answer will probably be recess. Children love to run and jump. Why is it then that for many children, some of the most boring classes are in the gymnasium? Educators think it's because the accent is on competition. Now there's a new way of learning gymnastics, and it's fun. These grade 2 children at Pierrefonds Greendale School may not know it, but they are being taught educational gymnastics. Some school boards and a number of provincial departments of education are encouraging gym teachers to conduct lessons in which children do not feel that they must compete with each other in performing some particular stunt. Suppose it were suggested that it's possible to compete with yourself. And suppose that a teacher told you how. Imagination and physical abilities are important, but these things are yours, nobody else's. Here, for example, a teacher has just asked her class to balance and stretch, and she's issued an unusual instruction. Make a long shape or a wide shape with your bodies. Imagination is required, no doubt, but the children respond.
Much better, good girl.
At McGill University, Jane Hodge instructs student teachers in this alternate approach to gymnastics.
Well, we don't want the children to give just any old half-hearted answer to the problem that the teacher has set. The children will judge themselves on the basis of how wide their shape is, how long and thin the shape is, how round and small the shape is. And then if they put these movements together in a sequence that is interesting, well put together, it's the quality of the movement that becomes important rather than the sophistication of it. Through this approach, the children become very aware of the shape and the movements that their bodies are capable of. And not only that, but they are thinking about what they're doing.
What I like best about gymnastics is when the teacher asks us to try and figure out different ways to use body shapes. It's fun, you're always moving.
I like competing against myself and nobody else.
It's perfectly normal for a child to monkey around during a gymnastics class. That, too, is part of learning. But whenever a child's classmates make fun of him because of his lack of skill, he seeks other means of showing off, usually by clowning around. The educational gymnastics approach gets around this problem of self-discipline by having children learn that they can succeed no matter how advanced their skills are. The learning climate is creative, not competitive.
It's not easy for the teacher to learn this approach, but the results are terrific.
There's only a handful of schools in the province using this new form of teaching gymnastics. It's in the pilot stages, but if the advocates of the program get their way, it will be the growing trend in schools right across the province. You'll know when the program hits your school because your children will stop telling you their favorite subject is recess and start telling you they like gym best.